Hello, gamers, simmers, and pilots. I am the Killer Gamer, and we're back here with the tour around the world featuring Sublogic Flight Simulator 2 for the Commodore Amiga. And specifically, this is an emulated Amiga 500. I know back in the day with real hardware, the Amiga 500 and probably the Amiga 1000, I didn't have a 1000. But those played Flight Simulator 2 the way they were supposed to. Amiga 2000 also. But then, I never had a 3000, but I did have a 4000, and it just did not work right. And I think that was either because of the processor upgrade or the operating system upgrade. It's kind of interesting, but it just did not work correctly. But when this came out, it came out somewhere between the Amiga 1000 and the Amiga 500. So that is the best machine, best real machine to use it on, or the Amiga 2000. If you're wanting to expand your computer with some graphics cards and stuff like that, do emulation. I had a 2000. Loved the Amiga 2000, had the video toaster for it. And then eventually I got an Amiga 4000 and upgraded. I sent that toaster in to NewTek and they changed it over. I want to say it was free, but I don't think it was. But I don't know how much I paid, but I got an upgrade to the Toaster 4000 board. And oh my goodness, the discs, everything was on floppy. It was like 40 floppies or some ridiculous amount. And the sad thing is those things degrade over time. So I don't even know if you could even get a toaster system working these days with all those floppies. So I don't know, hopefully someone's made images of those floppies or put them together to where you can just install it now on a CD-ROM or something like that. I think eventually on one of the toaster upgrades they did release it on a CD-ROM, so you didn't have to use floppies. But I know when I first started it was all floppy disk. And I kept wondering, oh no, is one of these discs not going to work? But no, I got it all installed. Man, those are the good old days. Those were the good old days. And you can't get the video toaster to work on an emulator because it requires that graphics slot. It's not a Zorro slot. What was it called? Just a video slot, I think. I think it was just called the video slot. But yeah. And none of these emulators will emulate that video slot. You have to actually, it really requires the hardware to do that. But there are some great things with the Amiga. The wipes and stuff are so they're so dated as far as the timing and stuff, but they're fun. They're fun little wipes and transitions and stuff for videos. I would love to get those again and just kind of play around with those with these other videos that I do. But anyway, I digress, because you're here to enjoy a flight, and a flight you should have. And let's talk about that flight. We're right here in Canada, right on the edge there, and Sarnia, and we got a short flight this time. We're going to be going to London. And that would be Ontario, not England. We're just flying this way. And we have a VOR right there, the London VOR 117.2. We tune it in, and away we go. Just tune it in and head that direction. Should be able to find a runway here that we can line up with, and we can land. All right, 117.2, here we go. Change nav to. There we go, 117.2. It is 58 miles away. Not a bad flight at all. All right. So, let's go down to the end of the runway there, and we'll turn around and we'll take off. Drop a degree of flaps for takeoff. I think we're ready. That nice, graceful takeoff there. Land the gear up. Flaps up. So the altimeter there at London is 900 and some feet, so we're going to fly around 4,000 feet. It's already in our autopilot functions, so just turn that on and we'll be good to go. That's Lake Huron right there. Alright, we got a little bit of time before we get to the airport, so I'm going to work on the navigation. If you want to follow along with me, you just, as far as what I'm doing here, we're at a heading of 094, we're going to intercept the 062 radial, and we're going to fly that towards the airport. Or actually, what I meant to do, let's change this so I can see what heading we need to go. Actually, I think we're on the right heading. Wow, yes we are. We're going right to the airport right now. Look at that. Okay. I guess we can both sit back and relax. I'll see you before we land. All right. Back with you. London is right there. That yellow splotch, that's the city. And the London Airport is right in front of us. We are 10 miles away. We're going to drop a degree of flaps here. We got our landing gear down. And I think I see one of the runways. And we're just about lined up with it. To drop another degree of flaps because we're going 80 knots. I don't want to go that fast. 2,500 feet. We got another 1,500 feet to go to descend. You can see the runway. That center line looks really thick. Park right over here. We are touched down. Welcome to not England. It is London in Canada, Ontario, Canada. All right. Well, we're going to keep traveling in Canada from this point. There's only so much coverage. There's not really a lot of coverage. But hey, at least at least we're flying in Canada, and we'll be doing that for the next several episodes, possibly the rest of the year. I'd have to check my schedule that I have, because I have the whole flight plan figured out, with the exception of Europe. That one I've got to figure out. But exciting times. Thanks for watching. I'll see you on the next episode. Have a killer awesome day.